Late.
Late for what?
My first day.
Oh, good morning, Miss Hayes.
Is it always like this?
Like what? Oh, let me show you to your office.
Doesn't it seem a bit quiet to you?
This is our slow time.
Mornings?
Well,
Monday?
Kind of.
Spring?
The 80s.
Pardon me?
The phones don't ring. I've been here at least 10 minutes and there hasn't been a single ring. The phones don't ring.
Is that all? It's just a small service problem. I'm having it looked into. What else?
There's no one in the waiting room. No one is waiting to see us.
You know, it's a vicious cycle. The damn elevators are under Fritz. Can't get anybody up here to fix the phone because the elevators aren't working. And you can't call anybody to fix the elevators because the phones aren't working. But now that I know you want to make it a priority...
I've made a terrible mistake.
What are you talking
about? There are
no
clients. There never have been any clients. There aren't going to be any clients, are there?
I'm not sure I understand the question.
Have you ever had a client?
What, you mean at this particular location? You're not being fair.
You're not being honest.
Wait a second. Give
what
it a chance.
Doing?
This is going to work,
detective.
Really.
I'm destitute.
Maddie,
I should be selling
Maddie,
my house,
Maddie, listen
my
to
car.
Me. I have a client coming in. A big client.
You do?
But you're at 11:30. Sure I do. Of course I do. Would I say I did if I didn't? Remember, if you can't say anything nice.
What's this client's name?
What kind of question is that? What does it matter? The only thing that matters is that he is going to be here in 20 minutes for a meeting with you and me.
20 minutes?
20 minutes. Isn't it worth waiting around another 20 minutes?
20 minutes.
Now, this is how I always imagined it would be with a partner. Two people working shoulder to shoulder, seeing eye to eye.
Eating hand to mouth.
Penciling you in for a lot of lunches, kiddo. Take my messages.
Messages?
Have a nice day.
Psst. Rex, tough. Building security. Look nonchalant.
Excuse
me. Nonchalant.
Nonchalanter.
That man over there?
That's Mr. Rye. He's waiting for Mr. Taylor.
Mr. Rye? Is that what he's calling himself? Okay, here it is. We have reason to believe that man is carrying a bomb in his briefcase. Don't look. Just do what I say. Do exactly as I say. Nod your head once if you understand. Beauty and brains. Wow. I want you to introduce me to him as Mr. Taylor's assistant. I'm going to try and lure him into leaving with me. Don't be nervous, I'm a professional. Listen, if we do live through this, I'd very much like to see you again. Do you think that'd be possible? You do that, great. Okay. Let's get the show on the road.
Mr. Rye? This is Mr. Tough, Mr. Taylor's assistant.
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. Rye. Mr. Taylor's been delayed. In the meantime, I'd like to get some preliminary information about your case in my office.
Certainly.
I'll get that for you.
Mr. Tough, just where is this office of yours?
Call me, Mr. Rye. My name isn't Tough, and I don't work for Regency Investigations. My name is Addison, David Addison, and I'd like the opportunity to take care of all your investigatory needs. We solve no crime before it's time.
Oh, I'll keep in touch to see how things are going. Miss Hayes?
Mr. Rye. We have a real case.
Hey, do bears bear? Do bees bee?
This is gonna work. We're really gonna do this.
Yes, we're really gonna do this. What do you think, I'm playing around here or something?
If I wasn't so happy, I'd feel terrible. You know when you told me we had a client at 11:30?
You didn't believe me. Well, I am shocked and appalled.
David, we have a case.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. And this is just the beginning. Soon, we'll be handling it all. Robbery, grand larceny, felonious assault, felonious with no salt, and even the big M.
What are you doing now?
Looking up the word nefarious. He said his son might be involved in something nefarious, so I... Nefarious. Something unspeakably wicked.
Unspeakably wicked?
That's what it says. Piece of cake.
Has to be an easier way. We've talked to newspaper people, the police, the DA's office, and none of them have ever heard of Michael Rye, much less know where he is. He's either the most amazing criminal alive or no criminal at all.
Relax.
Relax. How can I relax? This is our first big case. Our first case, period, and we haven't even got the tiniest clue as to how to solve it.
Ask me about Plan B.
You have a Plan B?
Amazing but true.
Doing here?
This is a bar where a lot of nefarious types go to get wrecked. Kind of a union hiring hall for ex-cons, arsonists, robbers, rapists, colorful people like that.
Oh, is this your regular hangout? Or does this have something to do with the case?
Figure I'd wander in there, mention our boy's name, see if I got any kind of reaction. If he's any kind of anybody, they'll know about him in here.
What about me?
What about you? You keep the windows up, your head down, the doors locked. And don't play the radio. It kills the battery. Maddie.
David.
Wait in the car.
I don't want to wait in the car. I don't have to wait in the car. It's my car. It's my detective agency, and I don't have to do anything that I don't want to do.
You are going to get such a licking when your father
Besides,
gets home.
Besides, what's the point of being boss if every time you turn around, somebody's telling you what to do? Sitting in a car alone on a scary street is not my idea of F-U-N, David, particularly when I'm paying for the car.
Maddie,
what are
you
doing? I
can't take you in there with me.
Do I embarrass you?
This has nothing to do with embarrassing me. This bar is filled with punks and killers.
Don't you want me to meet your friends?
They are not my friends. Don't you understand? The only people in that bar are outlaws, street people. I take you in there and they're going to know in a minute and a half that you don't belong.
I can look different. I have lots of looks. Remember, I was a model.
This isn't like that. This has more to do with attitude, and you just don't have the right attitude.
How do you know?
You just don't belong in there.
You won't even let me try. What kind of attitude?
It's just not something someone can tell you. You either have it or you don't have it.
Let's just forget this whole detective business.
What are you talking about?
You can
about?
Just take me home. I'm talking about us being in business. What's the point if you won't even let me try?
Okay. All right, come here.
I can do anything if you'll just give me a chance.
Unbutton that.
Excuse me?
Unbutton that button. People with an attitude do a little advertising. One more. There you are.
There I am, all right.
Shake your do.
Shake my what?
Your hair. Shake your do. Girls with an attitude don't have a do like that. Nuns and librarians don't have a do like that. You want to have an attitude? You gotta shake it.
Do you have any idea how much this do cost?
Shake it.
I'm gonna tell Mr. Bruce that you made me do this.
Makes all the difference in the world.
All right, Henry Higgins, can we go in now?
Not quite.
Now what are you doing?
Don't worry, this will only hurt a second. Not a bad attitude at all. All right, now let me see you move.
Move?
Walk, you know, one foot in front of the other.
I can't wait till we have to go to a society party. Will you be in trouble?
Let's put a little motion in the ocean, kid. There she was, just walking down the street, singing, do what did it, did it, dum, did it, do. That's what you say. You're gonna blow it for Miss Congeniality. She looked good. She looked fine. She looked good. She looked fine. Yeah, she nearly broke my mind.
Button, that button. What are you trying to do? Start a riot? And do something with your hair for crying out loud. All right, let me handle this.
Hey, my man, all right.
Now this man has his attitude down pat.
Long time no see. Yo, you remember me, right? Sure you do. Oh, me? You're looking great, kid. No, really, you are really looking great.
Get down pat.
You got a light?
Guess not.
How am I doing?
I'm taking notes.
Look here, cuz. How about some drinks? What do you say you set me up with 7, maybe 8 tequilas? Better yet, make it a baker's dozen.
You want 13 tequilas, man?
To go. I come here all the time. They're very fast.
What is your story, man?
Me? I was born in a little town just outside of Philadelphia.
Now you're starting to tick me off, pal.
Man.
Too late to apologize? I'm taking my bones and going home.
All right, what do you want? Now, you don't belong here.
We're just looking for somebody, that's all.
Well, you've looked in the wrong place. People don't come here to be found, they come here to get lost.
I can't believe you're talking to this guy. Didn't you see him shot put me across the bar? I know you think I've forgotten, but I haven't. I'm still mad at you, Tiny.